Even before the Darknet, people were trying to profit in the gray area of the law. In February 2012, authorities executed a warrant for tax evasion and embezzlement at the apartment of a reclusive old man in Munich. Cornelius Gurlitt had been detained on a train from Zurich in 2010 with 9,000 euros on his person. Nothing illegal there, but when authorities looked into the matter, they found nothing. No history of employment, bank accounts, or pension. This was a man whose entire life didn't seem to exist. But what did exist inside Gurlitt's modestly sized apartment was 121 framed and more than 1,200 unframed artworks by Picasso, Matisse, Chagall, Renoir, and paintings from the 16th century stuck in cupboards and stashed under beds. The collection was worth an estimated $1 billion. You see, Gurlitt's father was one of Adolf Hitler's top art dealers, and while buying pieces for the Führer's planned classical museum, the father was enriching his own private collection, buying art on the cheap from Jews desperately fleeing Nazi persecution, or liberating pieces left behind after their owners fled. Cornelius moved into the Munich apartment in 1960 with his father's ill-gotten art and remained there until his death in 2014, funding a life of near total seclusion among his priceless works with the occasional sale of one. You could say by hoarding art, Gurlitt was following in the footsteps of his father to protect national treasure, and he wouldn't be the first. Another father follower to protect his nation's treasures? Bill Gates, aka Nicolas Cage.